Welcome to day 22 of the Warhammer TV Advent Calendar. Now in this tutorial we'll be showing you how to do some general weathering effects as well as some chips and scratches too. Now this was asked for by Alistair Shaw but loads of others too. It's great fun to do and can really add some character to your army. So for the general weathering you're going to need some Rhinox hide and some Runefang steel. For the chips and scratches you'll need some Rhinox hide as well, and we're going to be using Dawn Yellow because that's the highlight colour for my Orc armour. However, use whatever highlight colour you're using for your armour. So we're going to start with the general weathering. So I'm going to grab my Rhinox hide, give it a good shape before I use it. Now, to apply this, I'll be using a bit of old sponge. What you want to do is just get it into your hand and just ball it up like that. So you get a nice pad to apply the paint with. I'm going to get some paint on there. Just use my palette just to get off most of the paint. And you want it so it's kind of like that. You don't want any smudging. And then I'm going to start on the claw here. Now you want to start applying it very lightly. It's much easier to add more paint than it is to take it away. You can see already just adding it onto the edges there and catching it. It's getting a really nice weathering effect. Just keep going and building this effect up until you're happy. And there we go. With the Rhinox hide applied, you can see that we're getting a really nice weathered effect starting to appear. You could leave it here because it does look quite nice and rusty. However, if you want to take it further and make it look like the paint has chipped away to reveal the metal underneath, you can do this next step, which is using Runefang steel. We're going to apply it in exactly the same way. So I'm going to grab my sponge and just get some Runefang steel and pop it onto the palette again. And we just want to work it into the sponge. And so there's almost no paint left, just like the Rhinox hide. So once you've done that, I'm going to start applying it really sparingly onto the claw. Now, you don't want to do too much because you don't want to overpower the Rhinox hide. You still want to see some underneath. So just be careful with this and keep going until you've got an effect that you're happy with. With the Runefang steel now applied, you can see that we've got a great weathered metal effect now. And the next thing we're going to do is add some chips and scratches to the model. And for that, we're going to go back to using Rhinox hide. And I'm going to use my artificer brush to apply these. So I'm just going to grab some paint onto the palette and also add just a touch of water so the paint flows on the model nice and smoothly. And we get a good point on a brush. And then I'm going to start on the claw again. And just start with a scratch. So for a scratch, what you need to do is just add a nice straight line wherever you want your scratch. So I'm going to do mine there. For a chip, you just want a nice random shape. It doesn't matter what shape it is. And just go around the model and add these as you like. Just remember to apply them in moderation and just have some fun with it. And there we go. That's all the chips and scratches now marked out. So the next thing we need to do is just add a highlight to create the illusion of depth. And for that, I'm going to be using Dawn Yellow, as that's the colour that I've used to highlight my armour. But as I've said earlier, just use whatever colour you're using to highlight your armour. So I'll be using my artificer brush to apply this. I'm just going to get a good amount of paint on the palette. And also add a little bit of water, just so it flows nice and smoothly on the model. Just add a little bit more. And twist my brush to get a good point. And then we'll be doing this scratch here. So I'm just going to, for this, you just need to add a small line underneath there, the same length. Just keep it nice and thin and straight. And that should create the illusion of depth. Because it'll be like the light's hitting it from above. And then for the chips, you just need to do exactly the same thing. Just go along the bottom edge, just like that. Just go along until you've got all of your chips and scratches. With those highlights done, that's the chips and scratches complete. And in fact, I'm really happy with how these have come out, and they were super fun to do too. And there's just a couple of things to remember when painting on your weathering effects to your model. So when you're sponging on the paint, just remember to start off sparingly and build up the effects slowly. It's much easier to add paint than it is to take it away. And also, when applying these weathering effects to your model, just remember that they're most effective when applied in moderation. Just try to resist the urge to get carried away. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and we'll see you again real soon for more.
If you enjoyed that tutorial and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to our YouTube channel, Warhammer TV, which is full of loads of other tutorials, but also trailers and miniature showcases too.
If you want to watch some right now, why not check out some of the videos down below?